Please welcome to the stage your international president, Therese Antonini.
Welcome to Sweet Adeline's International 75th Annual International Convention and Competition in Louisville, Kentucky. Louisville is known as a city where champions are made. It is home to Muhammad Ali, the Louisville Slugger, and of course, the Kentucky Derby. How appropriate that in a city that hosts the first jewel in the Triple Crown of horse racing, we will celebrate all of these this year's Sweet Adeline's champions with trophies, medals, roses, and yes, even crowns. Like every horse in the Kentucky Derby, every one of our competitors has worked hard to earn their spots at the starting gate. This year holds the promise of exciting starts, thrilling home stretches, and maybe even a photo finish or two. It is anybody's race in a field of outstanding performers, everyone a champion in the making. We have a very special treat for you. The Kentucky Derby starts with a bugler playing call to the post to start the race. To kick off our convention and competition, we are proud to welcome Steve Buttleman, the Churchill Downs official bugler for the past 27 years. Thank you, Steve, for joining us. Please call to post to start our week of family, support, encouragement, and competition. Thank you, Steve, for letting us enjoy a piece of the Kentucky Derby and kicking off our convention and competition. As we begin our week of celebration together, I would like to introduce you to a group of people who have already been hard at work. Your International Board of Directors began last weekend working on the creation of the foundation of our next three-year strategic plan, and they ended the weekend with our mid-year board meeting. It is an extraordinary honor for me to serve as president with this board, and I am equally honored to have the opportunity to acknowledge them in front of you, the people they work so diligently to serve. We are in good hands with the 2023-2024 Sweet Adeline's International Board of Directors. Board members, please join me on stage when your name is called. Our International Secretary, Jenny Harris. Our International Treasurer, Valerie Taylor. Our immediate past president, Joan Boutelier. Our president-elect, Mary Ray. Sharon Cartwright. Jean d'Arc, J.D. Crow. Annika Delos. Vicky Mabry. Janice McKenna. Julie Starr. And Mary Teed. Please join me in expressing our thanks for everything these dedicated people do for us and our organization. Jenny's getting out there in the lead. And now, to further express the reason that this group of people work so hard, we have a brief video to share with you.
Oh. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited.
It starts with singing. Rehearsal, one night a week.
Here I am at our rehearsal hall, and I've been coming here or other rehearsal halls we've had for the last 33 years.
A hobby. Because you need something for yourself. It becomes a home away from home.
På värmen och gemenskapen som vi har och musiken som vi skapar tillsammans.
A source of guidance and support.
Karen and I came in together and we have been through over 40 years.
Raised our children.
We went through lots of things personally.
Yes.
A special bond forms between singers who know each other's every breath. Anticipate each other's every move. And that bond.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life,
is unbreakable. Because you give your time.
More people experience the joy.
Singing barbershop? Is that what we're listening to?
Yes.
You want more barbershop? Okay.
Of barbershop singing. Because you give your voice, you are part of a beautiful harmony. Can create alone because of your generosity.
So this donation, it's being targeted to education.
All the bonds you formed, the chords you rang, those good times you had. And the lessons you learned.
We're going to sing in two choruses, and we are a mother-daughter duo.
Will carry on in the lives of singers for generations. All of it. Is possible because of Sweet Adeline's.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I am fearless.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can find a home anywhere in the world.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I am a part of a community filled with the most loving and generous women.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can do and I won't be alone.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can be more than a mom and a professional. I can be me.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I have more confidence.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I met my wife.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I now hold my head up when I walk down the street.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can share my passion for music.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can travel the world with my best friends, teaching, performing, and coaching.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, after I lost my husband, I found a new purpose in life.
Because of Sweet Adeline's, I can have this beautiful friendship, and I can have this in my life. Forever.
And Sweet Adeline's is possible because of you. Because of you, the legacy continues. Give now to keep the chords ringing.
Sit up there. I am honored once again this year as the International President to be presenting the state of the organization to you this evening. We are off to the races as we continue our transition into the future. To those of you who are here, it is wonderful to see you and connect with you live and in person. To those of you who are not physically here with us, welcome and thank you for joining us virtually. One of the greatest things I have learned throughout my years in Sweet Adelines, and particularly in my role as president, is the power of the members in our organization. I have watched performances that had me bent double laughing and performances that have moved me to tears. I have been welcomed into regions and chorus rehearsals around the world and felt immediately that I belonged. I have watched members celebrate moments of immense joy together. For example, I am very pleased to introduce you to my brand new grandson, Owen William. I can't even express how being able to share the news of his birth with you has magnified my joy. And I know that you have done that for each other over and over again. I have also watched as our members have sustained each other through almost unbearable trials of sorrow and have forged relationships that will continue to sustain them throughout their lives. I realize now more than ever that this organization lives and breathes because you nurture and care for it. Recognizing that, this evening I plan to enlist your assistance in delivering the State of the Organization address. I believe that it will be clearly demonstrated that we are who we are because of you. Let's try this out. I will ask you a question about your experience as a Sweet Adeline, and by show of applause and or cheering, you will respond and indicate how this organization truly represents the state of our organization. So here we go. By show of applause and or cheering, how many of you have important relationships that have come into your life because of your membership in Sweet Adelines? What a glorious representation of how the way we treat each other is such an important part of our membership experience. Let's continue with one of the most important developments in the past year, the success of our Ignite the Sound membership growth campaign. We'll be celebrating more as the week goes on, but for now, we'll do a quick recap. Our goal for the campaign was 1,078 new members. By the end of the campaign, we had welcomed 1,750 new members, exceeding our goal by 62%. There can be absolutely no doubt that this result came directly from the brilliant and enthusiastic efforts of you, our members. Now that we know because of you that we can do it, we've set a goal of another 1,750 members this year, and we're already well on our way with 557 members as of October 16th. That's ahead of where we were last year at this time. To demonstrate that this success is yours to claim, please show by round of applause and or cheering between June 2022 and April 2023 how many of you welcomed someone new or welcomed someone back to the organization through membership in your chorus or quartet? Indeed, it could not be more clear that the success of this campaign is because of you. This year, one of the initiatives that we are most excited to bring to our members is our new learning management system. A learning management system is a platform that provides those creating education a user-friendly and consistent way to create content and assess progress. It provides participants with an engaging learning experience and with the flexibility to proceed with courses at their own pace, leave and resume where they left off, review and revisit materials as needed, and track their own progress. A very appealing aspect of providing this LMS to our members is that it will be accessible and responsive across all devices. iPhone, iPad, laptop, enabling access anytime, anywhere, and for any period of time. We are, at our core, an educational organization, and this new way of delivering education will enable us to provide great educational programs to each and every one of our members with even greater access and availability of our educational resources. And we are looking for an official launch early in 2024. We cannot wait to share this exciting new platform with you. To get a sense of how our members benefit from education throughout the organization, I'll turn to you again. Again, by show of applause, how many of you have learned something through Sweet Adelines that has impacted other areas of your life, be it professional, personal, or other musical pursuits? That demonstrates the impact that our organization is having in the world because of you. Special thanks are due again to Sarah Nine and Newhard for the generous initial gift that enabled us to put this initiative into real forward motion, and to Shelley Hughes and Mike Gerke and Linda Clements for your generous support directly enabling the conversion of the Director Certification Program to LMS. Because of you, we have been able to move one step closer to getting the LMS into our members' hands. Speaking of giving, the generosity of our members is clearly reflected in the results of philanthropy efforts. Philanthropy provides opportunities for those who want to give back to the organization to do so in the way that is most meaningful to them. Through our Life on a High Note campaign, each of us is able to support our members in the ways that are most personally meaningful. For example, Melody Wright designated a generous estate gift of $100,000 to support youth outreach to bring the joy of barbershop into the lives of young people. It's one of the many ways her light will continue to shine brightly for Sweet Adelines. And again. Whatever your favorite cause is, Susan Smith and our philanthropy resources can help you target your contribution exactly where you want it to go. Just give me one moment. This year, you will have even more ways to give, especially with the addition of our QR code. You'll see the QR code everywhere. You'll see it on convention signage, in the convention program, and on postcards. And it's right here up on the screen. You just scan it, walk through the steps to complete the process. This is an easy way to give from wherever you are located. You can also give through our website, sweetadelines.com/give. And another quick option for giving is text to give by texting the word support to 918-992-4838 with a little disclaimer that this is for U.S. phone numbers only. With all of that in mind, it's time again for us to reflect how much the state of our organization is all about you. Please share by way of your applause if you have contributed to our Life on a High Note Fund, or if you have benefited from it, or both. The connection that philanthropy fosters creates true partnership among our members. Sorry, I need to find my page. It's out of order here. The International Board of Directors, as I mentioned, met earlier last week to begin our strategic planning process for the years 2024 to 2027. We had an outstanding facilitator walk us through the process. And to begin with, the first thing she asked us was, where do you want Sweet Adelines to be in 10 years? We reconfirmed that our mission and vision statements, particularly the goal of harmonizing the world, will still remains valid for us and will inform the strategic plan going forward. We also confirmed that our guiding principles are an appropriate compass to move us forward. To phrase it at the highest level summary, we are committed to ensuring that this organization, one which exists and thrives because of you, is still here, strong and vibrant well into the future. I know you can appreciate that since the board just completed this planning session a few days ago, we still have much work to be done to finalize, document, and share our results with you. In the meantime, I would like to review our guiding principles and how they will combine to provide a compass for our way going forward. Our musical excellence guiding principle states, we honor and embrace artistry, education, and innovation in the performance of women's a cappella music while championing the barbershop style. For our strategic plan, we consider ourselves the stewards of the distinct characteristics of the barbershop style. We recognize that our exploration of other women's a cappella music is only just beginning, and we recognize that including it will contribute to an expanded richness of our singers' experiences. Our culture of belonging guiding principle states, we remain committed to creating harmony where every voice matters and fostering a culture that provides a joyful place to share our uniqueness within the global community, united in song. Our diversity, equity, and inclusion guiding principle states, we remain committed to celebrating our differences as essential to the rich harmony that unites us. We continue to recognize barbershop's African-American origins and learn from our exclusionary past toward women of color and to reject discrimination and unwaveringly strive toward greater awareness, openness, and understanding of each other. For the strategic planning process, we recognize that many of the activities that ensure we remain aligned with these two guiding principles are under the purview of the Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Council, which provides important input to the International Board of Directors. The inaugural DEI Council faced an extraordinary challenge as it was formed during the pandemic, which prevented them from meeting in person to connect and form as a team. These nine individuals rose to that challenge and, in spite of never meeting in person, established a foundation for us to move forward with this important work. This year, for the first time, the DEI Council did meet together in Tulsa, and they have laid out a plan for 2023 and 2024 that includes working towards a model of stronger integration of DEI principles across the organization. This will help ensure that the principles of DEI are present and integrated into our overall strategic plan. The Council has also prioritized their continuing education effort with a specific focus on the Chorus Toolkit and supporting RMTs for regional diversity, equity, and inclusion efforts. Our personal empowerment and leadership guiding principle states, we remain committed to our guiding principle of encouraging and empowering everyone to lead from where they stand. For our strategic purposes, the International Board of Directors recognizes that our strongest partners in supporting this guiding principle are our regional management teams, who have the ability to reach out and encourage regional members to excel. Our guiding principle of outreach states, we remain committed to building strong connection by sharing our love of barbershop harmony throughout our communities, countries, and the world. For strategic planning purposes, we will be focusing on our organizational presence across the world, striving to find ways to provide an equitable member experience to all of our members. Our next steps in our strategic planning process will be to define the pillars of the plan, which will be the goals that we will seek to achieve over the next 3 years, 2024 to 2027. Because of you, our objective is to define these goals specifically and with clarity and set them so they are achievable and measurable. This will position us to very intentionally and successfully move with you into the future. As I close, I want to recognize all and each of you again for being a part of this organization and for helping me out with this presentation this evening. It is likely each of you was a part of at least one of the applause responses tonight. And that is great proof that there is nothing that you do that doesn't count, nothing that you do that doesn't matter to someone. What seems small and easy to you may make all the difference in someone else's day. It is our connection with each other that makes this organization great and keeps us coming back to rehearsals and events like this. Sweet Adelines thrives because of you. Thank you for everything you do.